Well, where is that rain now?
Moving right over the I-35 corridor, the first wave, but I think we'll see a secondary push of scattered showers and thunderstorms later this morning as well. The latest look of live power Doppler, it's kind of just like pulling together little dots here that are forming a line right along I-35 in terms of these scattered areas of showers and thunderstorms. Now we have one county within our viewing area, southwest of the city, Anderson and Coffee County, where we do have a severe thunderstorm warning posted right over areas of Garnett over I-35. Wind gusts here could approach 50 to 60 miles an hour. Then we have just these garden variety thunderstorms right over areas of Paola, extending through Johnson County, Kansas, right up through areas of 49, Belton, 470 through Lee Summit, I-70, right over areas of Independence Center. You've got a quick downpour there, and we're going to watch all of this area for the potential of seeing some strong winds with these thunderstorms this morning. Everywhere you see the pink shading, which is almost all of our viewing area, almost 3 million, over 3.5 million, almost 3.5 million. We do have the potential of seeing some damaging winds potentially with some of these thunderstorms as we're moving through this morning. I think for most of us, it's just going to be noisy. You're going to have to dodge some rainfall as you're heading out for your morning routine to begin your Thursday. Here's a look at your forecast. We'll break it down for you kind of in segments for today. Middle 70s out the door this morning. Now the thunderstorms we have, I think that will give us just a little bit of heat relief. It's still going to be hot and humid this afternoon, but we won't be in the middle 90s like yesterday, instead topping out near 87 degrees for today. This is the newest update of your Storm Track 5 forecast track, right on the money with these scattered showers and thunderstorms. Notice through 8, 9 a.m. through our morning rush hour, I expect we're going to continue to deal with these scattered showers and thunderstorms across our area. By the lunch hour, we begin to dry out, and then as we're moving towards this afternoon, we will be watching out for isolated thunderstorms across our area. I have about a 20% chance of an isolated storm this afternoon, extending into this evening. The newest updates of your Security Bank 7-day forecast will keep those isolated storms in the forecast for tomorrow. We warm back up to 93 degrees. By Saturday, I think we may see another complex like this to begin your weekend, especially earlier in the morning on Saturday. So I have posted a Storm Track 5 weather alert to begin the weekend. But I think as a whole, your weekend looks mostly dry, which is some good news, but man, hot stuff, Gina, heading our way next week. It looks like we could make a surge here into the middle, maybe a few upper 90s next week, the hottest stretch we've seen so far this summer.